First thing is a big thank you to everyone who has subscribed to this channel, because since I made my last video, we have passed the milestone of 1,000 subscribers. So thanks to all of you who subscribed, and anyone who's watching who hasn't subscribed, please do so. Let's get to that 2,000 mark as quickly as possible. Now, for this week's video, doing something slightly different from before, because we're going to be looking at Angular, and specifically dependency injection in Angular. The reason I'm doing this is really twofold. One is we've been looking at dependency injection in the C#.NET world for quite a while, and I thought it'd be interesting just to look at how it's done in a different environment, the similarities and the differences. But also, on a broader idea, really about half of the work I do as a developer nowadays is using Angular. So I'm a full stack developer. I write backends, web APIs in C#.NET, and then the front end is pretty much all done in Angular. And so that's about half of the work I do. I thought it'd be interesting to do some videos on that, but it's really up to you. If you enjoy looking at the Angular stuff, then do let me know. But if you'd rather I went back and did more C#.NET, do let me know about that as well. But what we're going to look at is not Angular from the ground up. We're going to dive in with this particular feature, which is dependency injection. And just by way of a bit of reminder, the application we were looking at that I'd written using C#, using ASP.NET MVC, was this one where we had book reviews. So this is actually showing the C# application. So for a single title, we can have multiple reviews. And on the one page, we just list them all out. And then we have the summary page, which basically breaks it down, so you've only got one entry for each title, and then it's averaged the ratings that we had there before. And the real thing to mention about this approach of ASP.NET MVC, which is so different from Angular, is all of the hard work here is done on the server. So when I switch from the home page to the summary page, that goes back to the server. The server generates the HTML that we're basically seeing there, and then sends it back to the browser that simply displays it. When we're doing something like Angular, pretty much all of the work we do is done within the browser running in JavaScript. So when I switch between pages, as we'll see in an Angular application, then it doesn't need to go back to the server at all. It just does some work locally, which is much, much more efficient. What I'm going to do, though, is just show you quickly in Angular, really exactly the same application. And I've already created an Angular application, and as I said, it's very similar to what we had in MVC. So we've got the idea of a book review there. And so a book review has a title and a rating. And then I've also already created one injectable service, which is this book review repository service. And you can see what I've done here is I've actually created some mock data. In reality, this sort of repository would go back to a web API where it would get the data, which on the server side would be stored in the database or something like that. But that just overcomplicates matters. It's what you do in the real world. But here, let's just have some fake data. So I'm using that book review data type to create just some mock data. I think this is exactly the same as the data I had in the C# example. So we've got this array of reviews and various numbers filled in. So that's what we've got here, this book review repository service. And then that just has get reviews that gives us back all of those mock reviews, though it should, of course, be going to an API. We've then got a couple of components. So I've got a all reviews component that just picks up that repository service and use it to display the data. So the logic is in this TypeScript class called AllReviews component. But then associated with that, we have what's known as the template, AllReviews.component.html. And that is where we've basically got a table and we have that loop through of all of the reviews. But again, that looping all done within the browser. And then we've also got a review summary component, which at the moment just has nothing at all. So this is where we're going to make the changes. But let me run this up just to show you what we've got. Click that and let it do its thing. Then you can see it says it's compiled successfully. And now immediately we've got our Angular application up and running, looking very similar to the MVC one, but the styling's a bit different, obviously. But we've still got this book reviews from that all reviews component where we have the table displaying that information. And I've also got a menu in there. And if we switch to the summary, we can see there, although it's still got the table, there's no data in there because that's the thing for which we've currently got to provide data. So let's get on with that. Let's go back to Visual Studio Code. And what we want to have here is another one of these services. So we've already got the repository service. I've put that in a folder called services. And if I open up a command line in that folder, which is the best place to do it, I can then actually use a code generator to do most of the work for me. So what I'm going to do is say ng, again, the Angular command line, and in this case, generate. So this is how we generate new code. You could generate new code entirely by hand, just creating files, typing it in, but this gets you going much quicker. So ng generate, and then what I want is a service, and then I give it the name of the service. And so this one I'm going to be calling book reviews summary. Okay, I leave off the word service because that'll get added on by the code generation. And then if I return that, we should see that it creates actually a couple of things. It creates this book reviews summary.service.ts, and that's what I'm really interested in right now. It also creates this book reviews summary service.spec.ts. And you'll see that those spec.tss for every one of the items we've got in here. And that basically is where our unit testing goes. And I'll be talking about the unit testing of this in the next video, because as we've discussed already, unit testing and dependency injection work very much side by side. But it's nice to see that Angular takes it so seriously that by default, whenever you create a piece of software in one file, you have the parallel test file so that you're really encouraged to be writing unit tests. But I'm not going to do it for now, as I say, do those in the next video. But we've got our book review service, and we can see that the way it sets this up, we've got the class called book review summary service, and then we've got this thing at injectable. And at injectable is an example in TypeScript of a thing known as a decorator. So the at is the syntax that makes it a decorator, and then injectable is the specific kind. And a decorator is really pretty much in TypeScript the same as an attribute in C# and .NET. So attribute that we put in square brackets, like we have our test method or like you have serializable, that's what we're doing here. And this simply specifies to the system that this is a service that should be injectable, and also configures the way it's going to be injected. And that provided in root is just the simplest basic way of doing it. It just means it automatically is configured for injection. We'll see some variations on that in other videos as well. But that's what we've got there. And we'll see if we look at the existing service, similar sort of thing. So there's the injectable. That's what we've got. Let's now give this some functionality. And remember what we want to do here. We are trying to summarize the book reviews. And we've got to get those book reviews in the first place. So that means this service has to be injected with the other service, just like we saw in the previous example. And so what I'll do actually is just get hold of that class. And then in here, what I'm going to do is paste that in, put a colon, paste that in again, and then change that to lowercase. Use an import to get hold of where that actually is. That's a bit like a using in C#. And so what I've done there is declared that the constructor has a parameter called book review repository service with a lowercase b, and then is of type, and then that whole class. Then I'm going to use another neat little TypeScript trick, because if we were doing this in C#, remember how that typically worked? So we had our review aggregator, as we called it there. That had the repository injected into it, but then it stored it as a private member variable. And we could do that in TypeScript. In fact, we want to do that, but TypeScript has a really neat little shortcut, because if you have a constructor parameter, if you put the keyword private on there, you could do public as well, but private is what we want here, then that actually says not only take this as a parameter into the constructor, but create a private field called book review repository service to which we'll initialize it. Because it's such a common thing that you do, as we can see in the C#, we're doing it there, we're doing it there. Lots of times you just take something into the constructor and store it. TypeScript has this more concise syntax for doing exactly the same thing. And so we know that's going to work because we already know that this book review repository service is injectable. So what we now need to do is we need to give this a property. So I'm going to give this a public property. The default's public. You could put it in, but most people don't tend to in TypeScript. So we'll call this review summaries. And that is going to return an array of book review. Okay, so that's how we specify the return type. Now, actually, the code we need for this, again, if we look at the C#, it was really neat because C# gave us this group by function, which allowed us to cut down those multiple titles into one group for each title. Unfortunately, we don't have that in TypeScript. There are some third-party libraries that give you that sort of thing, but I'm not going to use those. I'm going to write a little bit more code to get this working. So what I'm going to do is declare a variable I'll just call result, and then we're going to say that equals, and then if I say this dot, there we can see it's got that book review repository service, which is what we created there by putting the keyword private on. That's what made it a member. So that's the first thing we do. From that, we're going to then get the reviews. And then this is the point at which in C# I was able to use that nice group by function that we don't have here. And so instead, I'm going to have to write a little bit of work for myself. I'm going to use a method called reduce, which basically will loop through the array of reviews and allow us to combine each individual review into a more simplified object. So that is then going to take two parameters. One I'll call reviews, which is this aggregated object, and the other one I'll call review, which is the individual item. Now this is what in C# we'd probably call a lambda function, but strictly speaking in TypeScript, we should call that an arrow function. And then I'm, to start with, simply just going to say return reviews, so the object we're aggregating. And then also I have to pass in here the initial value of that reviews that will then build up. So I do that like this. I'm going to say, as a second parameter, I say it's going to be an array, and then the type of the array is it's going to be an array of title, which is string, and then ratings, plural, which is going to be an array of numbers. And that itself is an array. Okay, so what's going to happen is it's just going to be an empty array that gets passed in first time, and then we're going to use each individual item to build that up. So what we then have to do is get hold of the item. So we'll say const item, and then we look in the reviews to see if we can find an item with the title matching the title of the review we're currently looking at. So called review.title. Okay, so that's either going to find one if there already is a review for Dr. No or whatever it is, and it's going to return null if not. So we can then test for that. We can say if item. So if there already is an item for this title, then we simply need to say item.ratings.push, and then we just push in this new rating. Whereas if we don't have an item, then it's obviously the first time we've been here. So here we're going to say reviews.push. And so we're going to create the brand new item with the title of whatever the review title is, and then with the ratings as a brand new array, currently containing just that one rating from the review. Okay, so it's going to come in. Reviews is going to be a completely empty array. Say the first review is for Dr. No. So in this case, we'll then, into that empty array, we'll push an entry for Dr. No containing the first rating for Dr. No. And then when we come around again, next time we get a review for Dr. No, we just push that on the end. So at the end of all this, if we've, say, got four different titles, if we just go back and look at the data, like we had it here. So basically, we'll have those four titles, but we haven't averaged the ratings yet. We've just got arrays containing all the values. So what we then do is we go through that array with a thing called a map, which just allows us to do a one-to-one correspondence with the value in the array and what's coming out. So here, we're just going to say a particular review, and again, use an arrow function, and what we're going to do is say this is going to return an object for obviously which we've got title, and that's going to be just the review title. But then we're going to have a rating, and that now has to be the average of all those ratings in the array. So again, we're going to use this reduce. So we're going to say review.ratings.reduce. And I'm going to use this simply to add up all of those ratings. So remember, to do an average, we add up all the values and then divide by the number of values. So I can do that with just a sum and a val. Just gives sum plus equals val. And then we start with zero. That's actually a much simpler example of the use of reduce than the previous one, just for producing a sum. So we start with zero, add each one on in turn. But then finally, we've got to remember, we divide that by review.ratings.length. And then finally, we've just got to do a quick typecast to make it aware that that is a book review. And if we look at that result, we can see the type of that result is actually array of book reviews. So really, I don't need to put it in a variable. I will just return that from there now. And we've got that all completely happy. So we go through all of the reviews. We convert them into an array of title with an array of ratings. And then we go through that and that array of ratings for each one we average. So slightly complicated there, but that's how we do it. But that's not really the important thing. The important thing is the injection. And so now what we do is we go to our review summary component and do the same trick here with the constructor. So we'll take our component we want to inject. And then in the constructor, we say private, put it in there as a variable with the lowercase b, and then give it type of that service class, and then get in the import. And now we simply can just return this dot book review summary service dot review summaries, and that should have everything working. And remember, I don't need to do anything special to rebuild. If I just save those files, we should see it's gone through a quick rebuild. But now if we go back to the application and go to the summary, we can see there we've got the summary information for those books. So structurally, that was very similar to what we had in the .NET application. The key points to look at: we need to declare our service with the injectable decorator, and that configures it for injection. We can change that configuration, but that's what we'll do to keep things simple. Obviously, writing the functionality, and then whenever you want to use a service, then you simply need to have it injected into the constructor. And simply the fact that we've got it of the right type makes that work, and we can use this trick of declaring it there as private. Probably one of the biggest differences you'll see from C# there is the fact that with C# injection, we typically declare an interface, and that's what we make injectable. So we have, for example, our home controller here expects an interface to a book repository, and then our actual work is done in an implementation of that interface. You can do that sort of thing in Angular and TypeScript as well, but because of the way that TypeScript is ultimately JavaScript and therefore weakly typed, it doesn't seem quite as necessary to have these interfaces to define rigidly what's going on. In some situations you might want to, but we don't always do that. But that's it, our first look at Angular, a very quick look at dependency injection. Next time, I'll show you how we can change that dependency injection so we can start injecting mock objects, which is absolutely essential if you want to do any kind of unit testing. So I hope you found that interesting. Do subscribe. As I say, I want to make that 2000. Do click like, and I'll see you next time.